Welcome to Vedic Mathematics Basis Base Values. We are approaching Terloki. Terloki is a formulation. It is a formulation of seven letters. These seven letters accept values range . This values range is of summation value 24, and the second letter ref and the sixth letter ka sequentially unfold three phases values. To have an insight about formulation Terloki, we have to first chase its composition as a sequence of seven steps parallel to the seven letters veiled for its composition. This chase will take us to the transcendental code values range of the seven letters of formulation Terloki. Of these seven letters, the second and the sixth letters, ref and ka, sequentially unfold as of values 1, 2, and 3, and the consonant ka unfolds values 1, 4, and 5 as ka Brahma and as ka Shiv. These sequential unfoldments will take us to values 24, 25 and 26 in the context of the unfoldment of the values of letter ref. Then further, the letter ka with its sequential unfoldments takes us to values 24. Therefore, in the context of the formulation Terloki, the first feature that it is a composition of seven letters, the second feature that it is of summation value 24, third feature that its letter ref sequentially unfolds as sequential values 1, 2, and 3, and the letter ka has a sequential unfoldment as of values 1, 4, and 5, and these both unfoldments takes us to a set of six values, 24, 25, 26, then 24, 28, and 30. These values are leading us to relevant specific geometric formats. Therefore, now sadhakas fulfilled with intensity of urge to acquire proper insight and to attain proper appropriate enlightenment about formulation Terloki shall revisit cube, a three-space body, which we have seen that is hypercube 3. It is of a fourfold manifestation layer 1, 2, 3, and 4. The first fold, the dimension fold, gives us a linear dimensional order. The second fold, boundary fold, gives us a spatial boundary. The third fold, domain fold, takes us to the solid domain. And the fourth fold, the origin fold, takes us to the creative origin. Let us now have a further insight about this structural setup. This structural setup, on the face of it, focuses upon the corner points, which are 8 in number. edges, which are 12 in number, surfaces, which are 6 in number, volume, which is 1 unit, and in addition, there is a 3-dimensional frame, and it makes a sum of 30 structural setups. Sadhukas fulfilled with intensity of urge to glimpse and imbibe the working steps of Vedic systems, shell, approach word formulations like Triloki, then reach at its letters range, which is a set of 7 letters, from the letters range to reach at the transcendental code values of individual letters, then the next step to reach at the summation value as a transcendental code value of the formulation itself. Let us recapitulate that simple rendering for the formulation Triloki is 3 spaces. 3, simple rendering means 3. Lok, simple rendering means dimensional space. 3-dimensional spaces set up. On the face of it, cube is a representative regular body of 3 space, and within a cube we can sequentially have the formats of an interval, square and a cube. This domain, this 3-space domain, the volume of 3-space, the volume of a cube, this permits us to reach within it, to swap it, to exhaust it by having a sequential triple steps of values 1, 2 and 3 as interval, square and a cube. The cube is a 3-dimensional body. It is a hypercube of 4 setup. This hypercube 4 setup is having a domain fold. Within a domain, we can reach at the 3 sequential steps. It amounts to that first 3 folds of hypercube 3 get wrapped up, get superimposed, gets simultaneous expression. These are as a spectrum, sequential spectrum unfolding itself, and these are also as compactified, unified, superimposed upon each other and merging their personalities within this particular domain. Therefore, to appreciate the structural setup of a cube, to appreciate Triloki formulation, to understand the geometric format of hypercube 3, to have an insight about the structures of a cube, the representative regular body of 3 space, which on the first face of it is taking us sequentially, firstly as a cube. This cube is a volume enveloped within a geometric envelope of 8 corner points, 12 edges and 6 surfaces. This makes 26. Therefore, 26 is the value of the geometric envelope of the cube. This geometric envelope is a one feature. Then if we to it add 1 unit because of the volume, then it gives us a setup of 27 structural components. These 27 value as it is permits an organization as 3^3. It means the linear dimensional frame of 3 linear dimensions becomes a solid dimensional frame of triple solid dimensions, but sequentially linear, spatial and then reaching at the solid dimensional frame. This solid dimensional frame of three solid dimensions, each dimension itself is a solid, is a setup which deserves to be comprehended in the context of a cube. A step ahead, when we are having a cube embedded with a three-dimensional frame as well, then it makes us a setup of 30 structural components. So sequentially, we are reaching at from the geometric envelope of 26 components to value 27, making it a three-dimensional frame of three solid dimensions, and then reaching at a value 30, which becomes the ultimate unfoldment of the formulation Terloki. The TCB value of formulation Terloki, which at initial stage is 24 and then ultimately reaches at value 30. This value 30 ultimately becomes parallel to the TCB value of Trimurti. We will be coming to this particular phase and stage subsequently, as at this stage we are interested that we should have a further insight about the setup of a cube, the representative regular body of three space. The three space is a three space content space. It gives a domain, three space domain, and then we see that we have reached that cube as of the format of hypercube 3 as a quadruple value setup, one space as dimension, two space giving us a spatial boundary, three space making it a solid domain, and four space making it a creative origin. We have also seen that when instead of a three-dimensional frame of three linear dimensions, we are having a three-dimensional frame of three spatial dimensions, then the cube gets structured as eight subcubes. Three space splits into eight octants, and cube splits into eight subcubes. It is this split of a cube into eight subcubes which deserves to be chased properly, and this chase will give us an insight as that the center of the cube is a seat of the innermost corner points of eight subcubes. It becomes a seat of four space. It becomes a seat of the format of hypercube 4, a four space body which is enveloped between eight solids. One may have a pause here and take note that hypercube 4, a four space body, is a four space domain which is enveloped within a solid boundary of eight components. Now each cube as of value 3 and 8 of them makes it a value 24. It becomes parallel to the TCB value of formulation Terloki. As such, one feature of the formulation Terloki is that it focuses upon the solid boundary of eight components of hypercube 4. However, if we have a fresh visit to the setup of the cube itself, we will be comprehending as that the cube is uniquely structured. Cube is a structural setup whose geometric envelope is of 26 components, 8 corner points, 12 edges, and 6 surfaces. These corner points again are unique, as that in each corner point is embedded a three-dimensional frame. In each corner point is embedded a three-dimensional frame. Therefore, this structural setup as it is in fact a setup of as many as 8 three-dimensional frames. Therefore, these 8 three-dimensional frames make and give us a value of 3 into 8 is equal to 24 dimensions, dimensional axis. The formulation Terlocki as such also brings us face to face with its TCB value 24, which also takes us to a setup of the three-dimensional frames embedded in each of the 8 corner points. Previously we have seen that this value 24 also brings us face to face with a setup of a 4 space enveloped within a solid boundary of 8 components, leading to the structural components 24, a value which is parallel to the TCB value of formulation Terlocki. One way to reach at value 24 will be that we are having as many as 8 corner points as origin points, and origin points are of the three-dimensional frames. Let us further have a pause here and take note that 4th space is hypercube 4 body, is a fourfold manifestation layer, and here the dimensional frame is of a spatial order. Here 2 space plays the role of a dimension. Value 2 is to work as a unit. Once we are working 2 as 1. Once we are working 2 as a 1, it will give us 1 as of value half. Let us now revisit the structural setup of three-dimensional frames embedded in the corner points. It would be blissful to take note that these three-dimensional frames are in fact three-dimensional frames of half dimensions, as other half set of half dimensions are unmanifest form. These take us to outside space. Three-dimensional frame embedded within the corner point is a three-dimensional frame of half dimensions. The other set of three half dimensions are in the outer space. These are in unmanifest form. These in fact take us to space outside three space. Means if we are confined within a room, within a cube, then it will look like as if the space is a three space. But moment we come out of a cube, then the outside space doesn't remain a three space, it becomes a four space. The mental condition, because of being within a cube, being within a room, is a different thing. It melts away the moment we come out of it. Let us have a pause here. Let us revisit the structural setup of a cube. This structural setup of the cube as it is brings us face to face with the composition as that each corner point is the origin point. It is the origin point of a dimensional frame. The dimensional frame embedded within the corner point is a three-dimensional frame of half dimensions. Therefore, this structural setup of a cube having three-dimensional frames of half dimensions embedded within its corner point is the feature which deserves to be appreciated, deserves to be comprehended well. It is this comprehension which will bring us face to face with the difference of the axioms, this difference of the postulates, difference of the working steps of Vedic mathematics than that of the modern mathematics. modern mathematics and the Vedic mathematics differ at this initial stage itself, as that Vedic systems work out with half dimension, with value half. It is this working with value half is of a different features altogether. These features deserves to be appreciated. We will be coming to it afterwards when we will be working in detail three space mathematics and three space Vedic mathematics, science and technology as comparison to the mathematics of a four space and four space mathematics, science and technology. Three space is of a different mathematics, science and technology, and four space is of a different. So three space VMST is of different features than four space VMST. Here in three space we take one as one, but here in four space we take two as one and also one as two. Here there are parallel pair of systems in four space. It is because of the spatial dimension, and here we are having a linear dimensional order. Therefore, here when we have visualized that Triloki avails a set of seven letters, however, Trimurti avails a set of eight letters. We are acquainted how the modern mathematics feels that hypercircles increase from 1 to 7 and they go on decreasing from hypercircle 8 onwards. Why it is happening? Modern mathematics even is not in a position to visualize why it is happening. They are in a difficulty to reach at what are the defects, what are the limitations, what are the restrictions, what are the conditions, what are the features, what are the characteristics which are coming in the way of appreciation as to how and why hypercircle 1 to 7 onwards increase and hypercircles 8 onwards go on decreasing. However, the Vedic mathematics have transcended from this difficulty. Vedic mathematics have transited and transformed the setup of reach of linear axis dimensional frame of three space and has transcended to the spatial order dimensional frame of a four space and step ahead to the dimensional frame of five space, a solid dimensional frame. We will come into these features subsequently when we shall be working out three space mathematics and will be transiting from three space mathematics to four space mathematics. But for the present, we are concentrating upon the structural setup of the cube as a three space representative body as far as its external geometric envelope is concerned. Now, in each of the corner points is embedded a three-dimensional frame of half dimension. Now, a diagonal which coordinates this corner point with this corner point, and in the end points are embedded a pair of three-dimensional frames, and this diagonal becomes the translation path. This translation path passes through the center of the cube, a seat of origin space. Now, three-dimensional frame translates ahead towards the center, and when they reach at the center, then these take the shape and these cross each other, and while crossing, because of the structural setup of a four space, these synthesize. It is this synthesis process of a pair of three-dimensional frames of half dimensions and unifying as a three-dimensional frame of full dimensions. It is a feature, it is a value, it is a phenomenon which deserves to be comprehended well. It shall be comprehended fully. It should be appreciated thoroughly. And we know that the cube is having a set of four internal diagonals. These quadrupunal diagonals, there are four internal diagonals. These are the translation paths, and as such, while all the corner points, when there is a collapse of a cube upon its center, upon a four space sheet, upon hypercube 4, as a solid boundary, eight subcubes becoming the solid boundary components, the center becoming a sheet of 9 points, the innermost points of subcubes, then there were as many as a setup of 4 three-dimensional frames unified, and plus 1 three-dimensional frame, the original three-dimensional frame, because of which this structure has been. It makes a set of 5 solid three-dimensional frames. It takes us to 5 space. A reach from 3 space to 4 space to 5 space is a reach which deserves to be comprehended well. It is to be appreciated fully. It is with this comprehension that we will be knowing it, how Terloki will be ultimately taking us to value 30, how it will be taking us to Trimurti, and Trimurti means how it will be taking us to 4 space, 5 space and 6 space, as to how that 4 space, 5 space and 6 space are manifested within and remaining in unmanifest form, and these unfold. And this is how we say that Lord Brahma, the overlord of 4 space, Lord Shiv, the Lord of 5 space, Lord Vishnu, the Lord of 6 space, together being the Trimurti, these sustain our Terloki, creation, dissolution and sustenance of a Terloki is there because of a Trimurti. These are the features which deserves to be comprehended well. It is with the comprehension of these features that we shall be appreciating the difference between the axioms, postulates, working principles and the steps adopted by the Vedic mathematics, which are distinct and different from those of the modern mathematics. And it is by appreciation of these principles, it is by acceptance of these principles, it is by enlightenment of these principles, and it is by transition and unification of these values and axioms that we shall be acquiring proper insight into the Vedic mathematics. From tomorrow onwards, from the next lecture onwards, we shall be taking up three-space mathematics and how to transit therefrom, how to melt the mental block of the existing axioms, how to reach from linear order to a spatial order, how to work with two as a unit, and how to work unit as a half unit, as a pair of half units, two as a one and one as a two, are the phases, are the stages, and is the reach in terms of which we will be working out three-space mathematics as per the axioms of Vedic mathematics, and then we will be transiting from and the existing limitations of the modern mathematics, and then we will see how the problems being faced by the modern mathematics because of its restrictions of their axioms can be met with, and how blissfully we transit, and how the Vedic mathematics expands its domain. Thank you very much.